Good. Well, welcome to 10 Minute Tips using Adobe Connect. This session will be focusing on not necessarily how to use Adobe Connect, as in click here, click there, but best practices for using Adobe Connect. So before planning a session, think about why you'd like to include a synchronous event in your class. Adobe Connect isn't always the best choice, and there are other tools available that might be more appropriate. So it's important that you outline exactly what you want to accomplish and then choose the best tool based on that. Often I've seen people choose a tool first and then they struggle to kind of shove their content into it like the wrong piece of a puzzle, where you just keep trying to jam it into place because you're convinced that's what will work. But if you plan your content first, you'll be a lot more successful. So I wanted to start off by talking a little bit more about is Adobe Connect the best choice? Adobe Connect is a rather complex tool, and much like a Swiss Army knife, it includes a lot of different features, such as, and requires a lot of different capabilities on behalf of the person running it, such as training, planning time, equipment like a headset and microphone, and a good internet connection for not only the presenter, but also all the participants. For this reason, it's important to make sure that, again, this is the best tool for your purposes. So here's some scenarios when Adobe Connect isn't needed and you might want to go with a simpler tool such as Google Hangouts. So one, presenting a lecture for students that doesn't involve interactivity. For student meetings that where students are just working in groups with one another and don't have any active instructor participation. A meeting where you might want to share some Google Docs, maybe either between students or between the instructor and students, and also for just informal team meetings. So I want to go over some basics of planning your session, and then we're going to dive into four scenarios about how you can best organize your Adobe Connect session if you run into those. So the first step in planning your session is to have an agenda. Post the agenda within the meeting room so that participants can see it and then adhere to it as closely as possible. Students have set aside their time and they want to get the biggest bang for their buck, so to speak. So the closer you can stick to your agenda, the less likely you are to kind of go off track. You should develop some ground rules and share your expectations with participants at the very start. Some of those things include how information will be shown, how will students interact, how will speakers, anybody that wants to use their audio, be recognized? And then that brings up another question. Will you use just the chat like we have below in the right corner, or will you let students actively use their microphones throughout the session? And depending on your purpose for the session will depend on your answers to each of those questions. Then when you start your session, you should allow a few minutes for introductions and general dialogue. This helps to enhance the social presence for the environment and ensures that students are comfortable not only in the classroom, but also are more comfortable than interacting with one another and with the instructor. You should involve as many students as possible as early in the session as you can to avoid those students that just put their microphones on mute and sit back and relax and don't actively participate. And some ways that you can do that are to ask questions of specific students, have students use the hands up feature to agree with statements, use the polling tool, take a tally of participation and maybe call on those who are a little more hesitant to jump into the conversation. Use popcorn or round robin methods. So once you call on one student to speak, then you can have that student call on the next student, or you can just set an order for students to participate and then just go quickly around the room and have everybody put in their 2 cents. Then at the end of the session, you should conclude with a summary of key points and also reminders for next steps in the course. And conclude the session on time or early if possible, showing students that you're respectful of their time. So like I mentioned, there's 4 scenarios that I'm going to walk through in our last 5 minutes here of our 10 minute tips. And I want you to think about what you would need to consider in order to have this type of session. And I'm going to pose some various questions just for you to think about now and then later. So we have a social work instructor who wants students to be able to do an hour session from home instead of coming to class each week while they are in practicum placements. The goal of each week is to have 8 to 10 students share what is going on at their placement so that their peers can hear what others are doing. So what do you need to consider as that instructor? Some questions that you would want to think about. Do you need to see students? So would you need everybody to have a webcam and be able to have a strong enough bandwidth to support everyone having their webcam on? Or would it be sufficient to just hear them and have the microphones enabled? Do you plan to have breakout sessions where you break up those 8 to 10 students into even smaller groups, or do you plan to keep it at a large group setting? You would want to think about, what is the role of the instructor? Are they there as a facilitator to just facilitate the conversation? Are they there more as a mentor to offer advice based on the various situations students are experiencing? Or are they there as more of a content expert where they, where the instructor plans on maybe doing little mini lectures first? You should think about what you will do if a student doesn't show up. How will they make up that session? And also think about how you'll handle technical difficulties. And that's a question that you should consider in each of these scenarios. So then we have scenario B. An accounting instructor has 5 to 10 students in St. Paul. There are 1 to 3 students attending remotely from the Grand Rapids campus as they need the class to graduate. Most of the class is organized around short lectures and then small group work. Discussion of sample problems. So some things to consider. What format will the lectures take? How will you adjust them so the remote students can still see? Do students need to see you writing, quote unquote, on the board? Which leads you to think about, what technologies will you need access to? Will you need a video camera so that you can show that writing on the board? Perhaps you'd want a conference line to ensure that all the students in both rooms can communicate easily. Then you would want to think about also having a speakerphone in the main classroom with multiple speaking pods so that the students on the other in the Grand Rapids campus can hear. You would want to set an agenda in advance and provide it with the students in Grand Rapids, and also make sure to include frequent breaks so that everyone can get up and move around, since it is a 4-hour night class. And then you would want to think about, how will you break students apart for the small group work? Will you always partner the Grand Rapids students together, or will you need to figure out how students can form different groupings? Scenario C, a business instructor wants to give students the choice to attend one live discussion session in place of their online discussion. Students choose to attend one of the live sessions or do the written discussion in Blackboard for that week. So what do you need to consider? What if only one student shows up for the live discussion? Can students attend multiple live discussions if they demonstrate their ability to actively participate in their session? Can they then skip all the written discussions? How do you connect the two different discussions, the live and the written, so that students benefit from what was covered in both? Will you lead the live session, or have another student lead it, or perhaps just facilitate it to ensure everybody's able to participate? And then following up on that, how will you ensure that everybody is able to participate and more outspoken students don't dominate the discussion and the quieter student doesn't then just benefit from being able to sit there and not actively participate? And then how will this change the written discussion potentially? If there's fewer people participating in the written discussion, you might need to make some adjustments to that. Then the last scenario. An education faculty wants to bring in a local principal as a guest speaker to give a short presentation and then participate in a Q&A session with students. So this brings up a whole different set of questions that you'll want to think about in advance. How will the guest speaker participate? Will they be participating with webcam or just audio? Do they want to show something on the screen? If so, you'll want to request that they share those materials in advance and also set up a practice session with the speaker to ensure that their personal, whatever computer they'll be using will work with the Adobe Connect session. Will you have students brainstorm questions ahead of time, which will be sent to the presenter? Or will you require students to just have them ready and each student has to go around and ask a question? How will follow-up discussion work for any students that aren't present during the guest speaker? Will you have those students that aren't present or who couldn't attend view the recording and then highlight answers to any questions or ask follow-up questions? So all things to think about. And here in our last few seconds, the last word of advice is have a backup plan. When using any type of technology, you want to have a backup plan, and then you need to have a backup plan for your backup plan. Students have set aside valuable time to attend these sessions, and we want to make sure that we're respectful of it and also are prepared to deal with any technical difficulties or any issues that arise. So that is it for our first 10-minute tip session on Adobe Connect.